Happy day, children. In the previous session, we discussed about the preliminaries required for studying about properties on the set of rational numbers. The preliminary things were prerequisite knowledge, these were the capitulation, this we have studied already. Now we will go back to next in the topic is the properties on rational numbers. These properties on rational numbers, as you know, you have studied about properties on integers, properties on whole numbers, all this. There are main five properties: closure property, commutative property, associative property, existence of identity element, existence of inverse element. These are the properties, five properties discussed, I mean the various sets are checked for consistency of these five properties. And there is one more property, which is a distributive property. Distributive property of multiplication over addition, distributive property of multiplication over subtraction. That is separate, that we will study separately. Now we are in the set of rational numbers. We are going to check for that whether the properties hold good for the set of rational numbers or not, for the all four operations: addition, subtraction, multiplication, integration. For every property, we will check for these. If it is commutative property, all these four. If it is associative, all these four. But for existence of identity element and existence of inverse element, there is no meaning talking about existence identity element in subtraction and division. So we'll just go one by one. Let us take addition, closure property on rational numbers. So this is it, property addition. Okay, we take up what is closure property. Just recall that closure property means the set should be closed, means for the operation, for any operation, the resultant element after operation should be within that particular set. If it exists, the answer for the operation of any two elements of a set for a particular operation exists within that element, then you say it is closed. The closure property checks if a defined number set is closed under a defined operation or not. So here our defined number set is rational number set. Whether it is closed for defined operation means for addition, for we are going to do for addition. Okay, later on we'll go for subtraction and multiplication and division also. Okay, so the closure property checks if a defined number set is closed under a defined operation or not. That means for any two elements of a defined number set, you are taking any two element, any two elements of the defined number set, which is your rational number set, you take any two rational numbers when operated upon as by the defined operation, as defined by the operation, means your operation is addition. You know how it is done. So adding two rational numbers, okay, what the closure property does, the closure property checks if the resultant element belongs to the defined number set or not. So operating after addition of two rational numbers, the answer that you get, the sum that you get, is that necessarily a rational number? Yeah, it is. So that is what now specifically done for that rational number set. You are checking for closure property for addition. This is what you are going to check for. Later on you will do for this. So let us take two rational numbers. Randomly I have taken two. You know how to add them. So let us add them, see. So it is this, you are adding them, and it is equal to this, this. See, if you see this, 7 and 3 are different. The denominators are different. Therefore these are a kind of, you know, unlike rational numbers. Unlike rational numbers means you will have to make them like rational numbers by forming their equivalent. For equivalent, you need the base to be the LCM of 3 and 7. So the LCM of 3 and 7 is 21. So I will have to make these two as divided by 21 divided by 21, because there is here. So now 3 is there. 3 has become 21. How did it become 21? I'll have to multiply it by 7. So this 2 should also be multiplied by 7. So after multiplying 2, I will get 14, which will come here. And then now taking this term, this is 7. The 7 has become 21 now. The 7 has become 21, the second rational number. How is it become 21? You have multiplied it by 3. So the same 3 will be multiplied in the numerator also. You will get 15. So now it is like rational numbers, because the denominators 21 and 15 are same. Now you can perform the addition easily by keeping the denominator as it is. Like rational numbers, we can take 21 as it is, then add minus 14 with plus 15. So this is a negative 14 and positive 15. Red ball 14, blue ball 15. So there will be an excess of 1 blue ball. So it is plus 1 divided by plus 21, 1 by 21. So this is what it is. So we had randomly taken and check it. There's a rational number set is closed under addition. That is, for any two rational numbers, when added upon, the sum is again a rational number. So we are sure about it. So rational number set is closed under addition. And the sum will be inside the set of rational numbers only. So that we are saying addition is closed under this one. Next one, we go to addition after that subtraction comes. Closer property subtraction, that we are going to check now. So closer property check we do. Again, here the operation is, defined operation is subtraction, and the defined number set is rational number set. So when two rational numbers are taken and subtracted, the remainder that you get should be a rational number. That is what to be checked. So let us check rational numbers closure property for the operation subtraction, because for addition we have discussed it is closed, but for subtraction, is it closed? Let us check. Let us take any two rational numbers. Okay, 3 by 4 minus 5 by 6. I am going to subtract the first from the second. This is to be subtracted from this. So when you write it mathematically, minus 5 by 6 minus 3 by 4. So this is what it is, negative 5 by 6 minus 3 by 4. So you will have to take LCM of this. 6 and 4 are there. Okay, so to take LCM, how will you take LCM? 6 and 4, 12 is the LCM, you know it. Okay, if 6 is the bigger number, its multiples are 6, 2 are 12. 12 is divided by 4 also. So 6 is not divisible by 4. But the next multiple of 6 is 12, which is divisible by 4 also. So that is the least LCM also. Otherwise, you can use the common division method for finding LCM. So it is 12. So this 6 and 4 need to be written in terms of 12. Both should be made 12. The 6 made as 12. How does that 6 made as 12? 6, 2 are 12. So this numerator should also be multiplied by 2. Minus 5 multiplied by 2 minus 10 should come here. And then here 4 has become 12. Means 4, 3 are 12. So 3 are should come here, which is equal to 9. So 9 by 12. Now it is this. Now it is like rational numbers, the denominators being same. So now you can simply write, taking the denominator 12 as it is, and minus 10 minus 9. So which is equal to, they have written it in the form of this operation, and sine of 9 is plus 9. So subtracting a positive number becomes adding a negative number. So opposite of it. So it is minus 10 adding negative of, opposite of plus 9 is negative 9. So this is it. So it is in the next 19 minus 19 by 12. This is the answer for it. This is necessarily a rational number. You can take any two rational numbers and check for the remainder when one is subtracted from the other. You will find a rational number only. So for the operation subtraction also, the set Q, rational number set Q denoted by the letter 2, is closed. Okay, as the remainder when a rational number is subtracted from another rational number is a rational number again, because we are checking this one only. Okay, so now for subtraction it is closed. So next one is your multiplication. We will go to that next. We have seen addition and subtraction. Now we are going to multiplication. Closer property under multiplication. So again the same. Now when you multiply two rational numbers, the product that you get should be inside the rational number set. It should be a rational number. So that is what it is. Rational number set, closer property. For multiplication, you are going to check. So take any two rational numbers. It is this, and you multiply these two. When you multiply these two, minus 5 by 6 multiplied by 3 by 4. This is what it is. And you will have to write the sign of this number is minus 5 by 6. Sign of this number is plus 3 by 4. So when you multiply these two, minus into plus, that sign is all first multiplied. And then the magnitude 5 by 6 into 3 by 4 is. So minus into plus is minus. Here you can see that these two are 3 and 6 are reducible. So 5 into this 3 1 jar 3, 3 2 jar 6. So 5 into 1 divided by 2 into 4. I have shaken it and then I am getting like this. 5 into 1 divided by 2 into 4. So this is equal to 5 by 8. And the minus sign is there. So minus 5 by 8 is the answer. So now for multiplication also it is well defined. Okay. So you say that the set rational numbers denoted by the letter Q is closed under multiplication also. For any two rational numbers, the product is again a rational number. That is what the meaning of closure property. Next, coming to division problem. Closure property is just by see, you can see any two rational numbers you take, will you get the answer inside that set? Let us see. If you are dividing a number by 0, what will happen? So, the defined set is, number set is your rational number set. Operation is division. Okay. So, now we are checking. For all these three, we have already checked. Now, we are going to check for the division. Whether the rational number set is closed or not under the operation division. Let us take two rational numbers like this, and we will have to divide the second by the first. Divide the first by the second. First by the second. So, you are writing like this. Minus 5 by 6 divided by 3 by 4. This is what it is to be. So, this is equal to minus 5 by 6. The negative sign excluded. And 3 by 4 it is positive. Now, when you do it, minus divided by positive. Okay. It is equal to minus. And then 5 by 6 will become as it is. This division will become reciprocal of multiplication, and reciprocal of plus 3 by 4 will come. So it is again this minus 5 by 6 as it is, and into multiplied by reciprocal of 3 by 4 is 4 by 3. So that division operation is, division is rewritten as reverse of the digits, which is minus 5 by 6 has become, sorry, 3 by 4 has become 4 by 3. So in this one, we again multiply minus into plus minus, 5 4 jar, 6 3 jar. You can cancel it here. See, the 4 and 6 are cancelable. 2 2 jar 4, 2 3 jar 6. Or after multiplying the product also, you will be able to do like that. So if you do it here itself, it will be easy for you. So 4 and 6 are cancelable. But 5 and 6 are not, 5 and 3 are not. And 4 and 3 are not. So these two are cancelable. So when you do it, 2 2 jar 4, 2 3 jar 6, that is what written here. So it is 5 into 2 divided by 5, 3 into 3. So 5 2 jar 10, 3 3 jar 9 minus. This is what it is. Minus 10 by 9 is the answer for it. So for division also, but can you take by this example, can you generalize that for any rational number, any two rational numbers, the their division is again a rational number. I'll give you. You take the rational number 2 or any integer or any whole number. I'm taking 2 here. 2 is divided by 0. What is the answer?
2 divided by 0. Anything divided by 0.
It is not defined in the scope under scope of grade 8. So you will say it is not defined. Anything divided by 0 is not. So since 2 is a rational number and 0 is again a rational number, 2 divided by 0 is not defined. So you see that division is not closed for the rational number set. So we say, can we say that rational numbers close by considering the above problem? Can we say the rational numbers close by? So this is what the question here. So if you see that, no, VK is not closed. So you are taking that example of 2 divided by 0. Okay, both 2 and 0 are rational numbers, but 2 divided by 0 is not defined. Hence, division is not closed in the rational number set. Explicitly saying Q less 0 means that 0 element is removed from Q. The number 0 is not there in Q. So Q less 0 is then said. In that set, is it closed in a division? Yes. For all other numbers, division is closed, defined, and the answer exists. Therefore, Q less than 0 is not closed. Okay. But Q less 0 is closed. Okay. Q is not closed. See, and for division, Q is not closed under division, okay? But Q less 0 is closed under division. That's it. Next property, we are done for all the four operations. The property, closer property. Now coming to commutative property, we will check for all the four actions. So it is associative property, addition. Sorry, commutative property, this we had seen, now we are in commutative property. What is commutative property? You are taking two rational numbers, you are performing some operation like addition, or subtraction, or multiplication, or division, in some order. A is the first rational number, B is the second rational number, A into B. You are taking the operation as multiplication, A into B. You find the answer for A into B, product of A into B. Also, you find the product of B into A. Are the answers same? A into B and B into A give the same answer? Yes, you will be saying yes. Even if you are taking the operation addition, then also the commutative property is true. So now first let us check for addition. Okay, what is commutative property? Commutative property checks if a defined number set is commutative under a defined operation or not. That is, for any two elements of a defined number set, when operated upon in any order as defined in the operation, the commutative property checks if the resultant element is same or not. Okay, and the condition is true. We say that the given number set is commutative under that operation, otherwise not. You are taking two numbers, operate them in any order, so direct order or reverse order, the answer that you get should be same. If the answer that you get is same, means it is commutative, otherwise not. That's what it is. So now here the defined number set is your rational number set, and operator is your all the four, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. So we will check it now. You are taking two numbers, minus 2 by 3 and 5 by 7. You are going to check for addition is commutative or not. Means you will add first number with second. You will find the answer. In the second step, you will add second number with the first. Find the answer. And tell whether the answers are same or not. Okay. So let us take first number plus second number. Minus 2, negative 2 by 3 and 5 by 7 are added. So when you add it, it is already, you see, it is 3 and 7 are unlike, it's not same, so it is unlike rational numbers. So you will have to take LCM for 3 and 7. 21 is the LCM. So 21 is the LCM. This 3 has become 21. 3, 7 are 27. Therefore, Here also you have to multiply it with 7, minus 2, 7 is minus 14. Now 7, 3 is 21, okay, 5, 3 is 15. So this way you will write. Now the denominators are same and they are like rational numbers, so you can simply add them, keeping the denominator as plus 21 as it is. Add these two, plus negative 14 plus positive 15, which is equal to positive 1 divided by 21. So this is what commutative property for addition. Now we will go to reverse process of it. We have checked only for first step plus second. Now we will go for the reverse order, means second 5 by 7 is added with the first minus 2 by 3. In this case, what will it be? If you see, it will be the same thing. 7, 3 is 21. You will be saying it is 21, this is 1. And plus 15 plus minus 14 equal to minus 15. Plus 15 minus 14, which is equal to plus 1 by 21. You are getting the same answer in both the cases. Means you add in the direct order, the answer is same. In the reverse order also, the answer is same. So you find out that the rational number set is closed under the property, sorry, it is a commutative rational number, is rational number set under the operation addition is closed, is commutative. So next one, this is the fact that the rational number set is commutative under addition follows from the fact that the set of integers is commutative, because in all these minus 2, 7 comes here, minus 14, minus 15 comes here, 5 and minus 2 comes here, correspondingly plus 15 plus minus 14 comes here. Means it is an interchange of these two numbers. So A plus B, B plus A. Here it is integers. So the fact follows from integers. Integers are commutative under the operation addition. So similarly, rational numbers also, you are getting the same answer. It is commutative under the operation. Now let us go to the next one for subtraction. Okay, so here you are saying it is commutative. So now we have seen commutative for addition. For commutative property for subtraction, we will see. So you are taking any two numbers, you are finding the difference between them, or first number minus second number, or second number minus first number. Revise the order, okay, and find the answers. Will they be same? Not necessarily, not, because the fact of commutative property follows from the commutative property of integers for the operation subtraction. For the operation subtraction, the integer set is not commutative. 2 minus 5 equal is not equal to 5 minus 2. So the same thing follows here, that the rational number set is not commutative. Okay, defined number set is commutative under defined operations is. So rational number set you have taken, commutative property you are checking, addition check. Now for subtraction you are going to go. Clearly Q is not commutative under subtraction, as 5 is a rational number, minus 2 is a rational number. 5 minus of minus 2. Minus 2 subtracted from 5 is 7. But this one, minus 2 subtracted from minus 5. 5 subtracted from minus 2, we are getting minus 7. Here it is plus 7, here it is minus 7. So if the circles representing the two numbers are changed, then you cannot say that the subtraction will in any order will be equal. The subtraction will not be equal in the case of subtraction. Okay, so you say it's not commutative. The set of rational numbers is not commutative under subtraction. The next one, this follows from the fact of integers. Integers not commutative. So how can you expect about its superset rational number set? So that's you are saying, for any two rational numbers, when subtracted in any order, the sum is not the same. Okay, here they are given one as 5 minus 2, they are taking one this thing and then doing. Now next going to the operation multiplication. You have checked for commutative property for multiplication. So commutative property for multiplication, on clicking multiplication, any two rational numbers you take, multiply them in one order, reverse the order and find the product. Will they be equal? Yeah, they will be equal, because the fact that the rational number set is commutative follows from the fact that the integer set is commutative under the operation multiplication. So this is it. Now we'll have to go check for the operation multiplication. You will have to take two rational numbers and multiply them in direct order as well as in the reverse order, and check whether the products in both the cases are same or not. Let us take two rational numbers. These are the two rational numbers taken, and we are going to multiply them. So when you multiply them, minus 5 by 6 multiplied by 3 by 4. So this is equal to minus 5 by 6 plus into 3 by 4. This way you will write. Then signs will be multiplied. Minus multiplied by plus first. And then 5 by 6 multiplied by 3 by 4 will be there separately. So now you will have to simplify this. So 3 1 jar 3, 3 2 jar 6, you have simplified it by taking the common factors. 3 and 6 are reducible. So now 5 into 1 and 3 2 into 4 are coming, which is equal to 5 by 8, minus of 5 by 8. This is the answer when first is multiplied with 7. Let us multiply the second with the first. Reversing the order, 3 by 4 into minus 5 by 6. 3 by 4 and to minus 5 by 6. Here also it is going to be plus into minus. And 3 into 5, 4 into 6. This we have done. This will be equal to minus plus multiplied by minus into 3 into 5 by this one. This 3 1 jar 3, 3 2 jar will come here. Therefore 1 5 jar 5 and 4 2 jar 8. This is what the answer for it. On simplification, this is plus into minus is minus, 5 by 4 2 jar 8. So this is a commutative law proved for the operation multiplication. Q is commutative under the operation multiplication. For any two rational numbers, the product performed in any order is same, which follows from the fact that the set of integers is commutative under multiplication. So next one is, it is commutative that we have solved under now. Next one is your set of commutative property for the operation division. So I am clicking this. The commutative property, defined number set is your rational number set, defined operation is division. So you take commutative property for the operation addition and division only we are going to do, check. Otherwise you can get it typed or check, will uploaded by somebody else. So here is somewhat wrong. We are going to check for the rational number set for the property, commutative property. First we have checked for addition, subtraction, and we are going done for multiplication also. Now we are going to check for division. For addition it is commutative, for subtraction it is not commutative, for multiplication it is commutative. For division, what about division? Anything divided by 0 is not defined, so it is not that, we can dispose it like that. Clearly Q is not commutative under division, as Q is not closed under division. Division is not defined for the divisor 0. 5 divided by 0 or 1000 divided by 0, anything divided by 0 is not defined. So that's known to you, it is not closed, means you cannot talk about commutative property. So it is not closed. But the set Q less 0, removing the element 0 from the rational number set, can we say that the set Q less 0 commutative, not commutative under division? Yeah. 2 by 5, 2 is a rational number, 5 is a rational number. 2 by 5 and 5 by 2, are they same? No. 2 by 5 in one order, reversing the order, it is 5 by 2. So 2 by 5 and 5 by 2 are not equal. So it is, even after removing 0, it is not commutative anyway. So let us take any example, 12 divided by 4. 12 divided by 4 is 3. And when you take 4 divided by 12, reversing the order, you are getting this, it is 1 by 3. So 3 and 1 by 3 are not equal. So it is not commutative. Okay. Thus, the fact that the rational number set is not commutative under division follows from the fact that the set of integers is not commutative under division. So, it is not commutative. We will stop here. We will see for the other properties in the next class. The other properties are we are done up to division, associative property, existence of identity element and existence of inverse element. These are the three to be seen, and distributive property is also there. We will do it in another one or two sessions. Thank you, very kind of you. Have a good day. Keep watching the